acting stinking, treating you this way. Cause I've been acting like sour milk all on the floor. It's your fault, you didn't shut the refrigerator. Maybe that's the reason I've been acting so cold. If I could escape and recreate a place that's my own world, and I could be your favorite girl forever, perfectly together. And tell me, boy, now wouldn't that be sweet? If I could be sweet, I know I've been a real bad girl. I didn't mean for you to get hurt. We can make it better. And tell me, boy, now wouldn't that be sweet?
It's locked in.
That one might be the four.
There should be one.
Yes, Andy.
That's hysterical. Oh, I was like, that doesn't feel right. Right under the boat.
There should be one.
Oh yeah, that might actually gonna be close. I can't believe those fish yesterday we were catching her.
Beauty.
Bigger than this.
Absolute beauty.
Isn't that wild? No, it says a four.
Is it?
It's 403.
Cool. Well, because...
You're going to be right on top of her still.
Yeah, I know. Okay, so. Yeah, she's down there.
Yep. Oh, she's nice. This rod's built right. That's exactly what I wanted. She choked it, dude.
Nice.
Yeah, dude, check that out. I think she wanted that. She ate that thing. I was like, she's on the bed, and I felt, dink. I was like, uh-oh.
I'm gonna go mark it, because that one wasn't marked.
Yeah, she's not bad.
That's true. The ones yesterday didn't look that good.
She's not that big. She ate it quick though.
That's what's up, baby.
Oh, finally lost a craw after a handful of fish.
That one's worth it, though.
Oh, yeah. Nice. I was like, that's loading up a little bit.
That's awesome, dude.
Oh, yeah. That's a four, what do you call them?
I'm going to say...
4-3?
I'm going to say, yeah, 4-3. 4-3? Awesome, dude.
Look like, dude, she barely even fits on the freaking camera screen.
That's a good one.
Yeah, she's built right.
462.
460, nice.
say it's her, but usually it's not. Usually if the female's there, there's a male there. Ooh. Come on out. Ooh, got it. Yeah, you fucked that. Nope, that's the male.
Dude. Yeah, it's a male. You're good. No stress. I felt him smoke it. I can boat flip this one. Not gonna boat flip that one. Dude, see, look, I hit him, Kaden, I hit him as soon as he ate it.
Mm-hmm. Well, I saw him go down on it, you know. Actually, that was it, I guess.
The one?
Oh, yeah, there's a little baby male on this one. You little shit.
I think it's just a light spot.
Damn,
that's out of four. No. Yeah. Not bad.
Pretty girl.
Thank you, Dubai. Picture perfect. Crazy what happens when you actually set the hook upwards and you don't lose them that way.
Yeah. That one's probably a better one.
3.5. My last bunch has been. I'll just weigh that one for that. You're blind. I'm legally blind. Nice. Okay, nice fish.
She's down there. She's down it. Unless that's a rock.
No, she's there. Oh.
She got heat.
Yeah, she's not bad. Got it.
Oh, you just decked yourself. Sorry, hon.
But knocked herself out.
Better than 337.
That's better than 337. By like a lot. She helps the bag.
Your bloody tail.
Mm-hmm.
Your bloody tail.
Your bloody tail. Widowy.
Widowy.
Widowy for freaking bloody tail.
That basically puts that.
Good afternoon. I'm currently dealing with the hiccups, so if there's lots of cuts, that's why. They're kind of kicking my butt. There's one. Just got out of surgery for some kidney stones. I apologize that this video took an extra week to come out. This is gonna kill me. It was ready, but you know, unforeseen circumstances, we gotta take care of ourselves first, right? Ended up with 20 and a half pounds that day. I ended up filming an outro for this. I started having issues with my mics on this trip and didn't know until a few days in. So unfortunately, there's no outro clip for this. We're going to do it here. Unfortunately for us, this was actually a bad day out there. 20 pounds is never easy to come by anywhere you go for the most part. We were hoping for 25 back, but those big females just hadn't moved up yet. So we're kind of trying to find where some of the bigger males were. We found a couple females on beds. I think our biggest was like a 460, a lot of 4 to 4.5 pounders that day, so I can't really complain about it at all. This was the new bait that was doing all of the damage. This is the new Xzone Stealth Series Finesse Craw. It is a 2.25 inch craw, designed perfectly for Ned rigging on the bottom. I'm not sure what was up with the fish, but we were having a hard time getting them to commit to a drop shot in the morning. That played for us later in the day. But this little guy right here was the deal. I mean, I'm just holding it, and it's moving. But I think that you can, what that would do to the fish. Obviously did get some underwater eats of this bait as well as another. Our other big proponent was a drop shot with the hot shot minnow on it. These are my favorite bait of all time. They have a real neutral buoyancy. I've got it paired up with a VMC redline hook right now. These hooks are so light that it really kind of allows this bait to sit out at its neutral buoyancy and out here and look like this without it sinking too much. The heavier hook you put on these things, of course, are going to sink more. But what I really want to talk about is this combo right here, in addition to obviously this wonderful, wonderful craw that Xzone will be coming out with very, very shortly. They have officially announced the release of this. I'm super excited about these things. I'm going to have a bunch in my arsenal for every time that I go up north. This is the Daiwa Tatula 3000 size spinning reel. In my opinion, it is the best reel that you can buy right now. I'm not dropping $800 on Daiwa gear and stuff like that right now. This is a $200 spinning reel. That 3000 size, because it allows you to pick up line a little bit quicker and you get a little bit bigger drag star. I think once you kind of, and so you end up with some smoother drag coming out of your reel instead of that jumpy stuff. In terms of bigger sizes, you can go bigger. A lot of guys are starting to use 4000 series reels now, but I don't think that's necessary whatsoever. You want this to be as light in your hand as possible. I've got that currently paired with a Dobyns Kaden 711. I've had the 712 for a long time, and I was just like, man, if I had a little bit lighter tip and a little bit, I mean, these are fast in the backbone too. I was like, man, if I had a little bit lighter rod, this would be perfect for forward facing sonar. This would be perfect for drop shotting and Ned rigging. And let me tell you, it is the best mid-tier price rod that you can buy. It comes in at $189. You can guarantee that I will have this locked in my hand every time I'm doing forward-facing sonar, anything, or most things with a drop shot. I like to mix in the Champion XPs a lot, just because I have a couple and they are really nice rods. But this rod is really where it's at. So to all the guys that are telling you guys you need the $500 rods and whatnot, that's not true. I highly, highly recommend that you guys start to check some of this stuff out. The Tatula LT3000 and the Dobyns Kaden Series 711SF. I'm not sure if you can see that well right there. I'm going to zoom out a little bit here. I'm not entirely sure what you're going to be able to see right here or not. Ow! I stepped on a hook. Got my line here. That is a light rod, but it does not let me get into that backbone super quick. I am in love with this thing right now. And Dobyns absolutely hit it out of the park when they created this rod. I will be getting more. I just got to replace a couple more things. I got the rest of the diet order still coming in. I have some more reels coming in and whatnot, and I am pumped for those as well. We'll kind of be able to step up the bait caster game. But I love these reels so stinking much that I just ordered 4 of them to just completely replace every other spinning reel that I had. So, baits of choice. Scented Stealth Craw from Xzone. Hotshot Minnow from Xzone. These guys are making super crazy smallmouth baits that are just getting overlooked by a lot of people. And, you know, they obviously have largemouth stuff too, and that's getting overlooked right now too. I've been catching plenty of fish out here on Chickamauga, you know, using the 6-inch Deception Worm and the Muscleback Fat Finesse Worm. Had no issues at all. So hopefully we can keep bringing you guys some more underwater footage. Obviously, I'll probably not be diving in October when I go back up to Michigan, but for this one, it was okay. Stay tuned. I am down and out for a couple days because of surgery, so I should be able to get that next one out pretty fast too. Hopefully, I can get it scheduled. So even if, you know, when I go in for my next surgery, that one is still scheduled to post, and I don't have to worry about that. And we will go from there. Thank you for those of you who reached out to me and prayed for me for my surgeries that I had to have. I'm now I'm prone to kidney stones, and that one just got stuck, and I had it for 8 days, and the doctors kind of were like, hey, we can take care of that right now. So I appreciate it. Have an awesome day. I'll see you guys later. Follow for parts 3, 4, and 5 of the series, because this is going to be a fun time. This is going to be a fun series. I highly, highly recommend that you guys keep checking this one out. We're going to keep taking a step in the right direction with this professional footage stuff, and
yep.
And see where that can lead us. And hopefully, at the end of this year, I'll be able to get another boat. I'll get a kayak before that frog bite turns on Chickamauga. You guys know how it is. But yeah, smallmouth beatdown. You need Xzone Lures. You need Daiwa. And you need Dobyns. So those are the three things that you must have in your arsenal. Have a great day, guys.
Uh-oh. That didn't last very long. I told y'all, we stay on it. Taco Bell sluts want to win Mega Bucks.
Yep. Wow, 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 he's very nice.